A long, long time ago, our world was beaten, broken, and barren. After eons of endless battles between the four brothers, dawn, day, dusk, and night. With these unending conflicts never yielding a victor, finally the deities decided to negotiate peace. An agreement was struck where in turns one would rule over the entire mortal lands for a period of time, while the others would lay dormant. The lands prospered like never before, free from the destruction of war, celebrating the fortune of peace. But unfortunately, the slightest deviation from their normal waking order would crumble their whole delicate system. The world was held together with gentle transitions. Dawn returned light back into the world after night had covered it with darkness. Day released the script to pass control to dusk. Yet, even in harmony, protection was desired. Discreetly, one of the four brothers kept hidden a mighty remnant from the war, prepared to call upon his ancient weapon to manage and defend his domain. This is the awakening of Dawn's champion, Aru. The ceremony felt abnormal. There was a sense of urgency during the rites, and some were even omitted. Depart at once and wait for instructions at the border of my domain. From the grave tone of his master, Aru instantly felt the seriousness of his awakening.
Thank you.
Haru waited for his master's arrival with great anticipation. Surprisingly, Don appeared in his full form. His presence was captivating. Don addressed his faithful servant. His tone was anxious, lacking its usual calm and serenity. A dark menace unlike anything this world has ever seen is approaching fast from the domain of night. I am unable to reach it, so your time has come. You are to journey through the domains of my brethren and enter Night's territory to block its source. Ariel bowed his head. He needed no convincing. Ariel was determined to honor his master and follow his every command. Without hesitation, he stood up and advanced towards the realm of dead. Moving away from his master's presence, he heard his voice. Do not expect an easy passage through my brother's territories. They will not welcome you. As Ariel traveled towards today's glistening hot wasteland, he focused on the last vision his master had revealed to him. In his vision, Aruv saw four temples scattered throughout Day's domain. Destroying them should drain his life force enough to make passage over his lands possible. Aruv's vision ended. But wait, that had never happened before. Aruv felt a slithering wave of heavy emotions running through him. He needed to make a decision. Aruv had never felt so isolated. His master had always guided his every move, but now, such a simple decision, but somehow the most difficult task he had ever faced. Which temple should he start with? the temples destroyed, Eru intended to continue his mission and rush towards Dusk's border. But much to his surprise, he felt a peculiar yet familiar sensation run through him. Eru felt somehow completed, and his doubts seemed to melt away. Until an alien voice sounded to him, firm and without mercy. My brother has no right to send his minion into my domain. You do not know what you are doing. Go back to where you came from. You are not allowed to enter Dusk's domain, only to wreak the same havoc you have caused here. In an instant, the comfortable sensation vanished, and Eru was left hollow and alone once more. He found himself looking at three magical orbs, and wondered about their purpose.
Thank you.
Ariel flew through the portal and found himself on the edge of Dust's domain. He was filled with deep-rooted anxiety. His resolve had suffered severely by Day's rage, an overpowering reaction to the injustice suffered by his domain. Ariel pulled himself together and willed his mind away from doubt and hesitation. He focused on the importance of his quest and his determination to abide by his master's wishes. Kira's persistence and power defined Eru's every step as he moved towards the last temple in Dust's domain. Suddenly, he sensed Dust's calm and soothing presence. Eru's stride almost faltered when he heard the gentle yet resolute voice of Dust. I will not allow Dawn's fiend to venture into my domain and murder my children.
Yeah.
After the battle, Aru's emotions mirrored the fading light of Dust's domain. Dust did not show anger, only sorrow and disappointment. He asked Aru, "How have we wronged Dawn? What possible reason does he have to invade our lands, murder our children, and threaten our delicate balance?" Aru stood in silence. He could not possibly know the answer. In fact, he had not even considered asking the question. It was not his place to do so. As Aru entered Knight's domain, he was starting to feel unsure of his motives, and was unable to understand the feeling of regret that was slowly consuming his resolve. But his loyalty to his master kept up his motivation and drive, so he continued on to the temples of Knight. Knight's domain was unlike anything Aru had ever seen. Much to his surprise, the world was illuminated by the tantalizing glow of distant stars, which gave an unyielding feeling of serenity and stillness. Aru heard the soft, dreamy voice of Knight echoing, "Do you know that you are committing a mortal sin? You have no excuse." Aru did not respond. Knight continued, "Blind obedience will bring only sorrow. One should always question authority. Otherwise, the road to destruction is certain." Aru continued his journey towards one of Knight's temples. His heart was heavy and he was confused. He felt unsure of his mission and his purpose.